We can express the reaction rate either in terms of the rate of change in the concentration of a reactant or through a rate law. These two can be combined to give us equations where we can express the concentration of a reactant as a function of time. In this course, we will limit ourselves to the equations for first-order reactions. Equations exist for higher-order reactions, and they are not necessarily any harder to derive or apply. But for our purposes, applications to first-order reactions will highlight their utility. Imagine that we have a reaction that is first-order with respect to reactant A. No other reactant has influence on the reaction rate. Our two expressions for the reactant rate can be combined, then the terms involving the concentration can be grouped on one side, and each side can be integrated to yield the final expression. It can be expressed either in a logarithmic form or in an exponential form. The value of A0 is the concentration of A at time t equals 0. However, we can actually define this time at any point in the reaction and define our time t relative to this time value. Note that the logarithmic form is very useful to find the time required to obtain a given concentration of A, and the exponential form is very useful to find the concentration of A at any given time t. A half-life, t half, is the time required for the concentration of a reactant to be cut in half. By definition, it is the time required to go from A0 to A0 over 2. Plugging this into the logarithmic form of a first-order reaction, we obtain an expression that depends only on the rate constant k. This is important, as it means that the half-life of a first-order reaction does not depend on the initial concentration. This is not the case for any other order of reaction. Therefore, the time required to go from 100% to 50%, the initial value, or from 50% to 25%, or from 25% to 12.5%, are all one and the same when dealing with a first-order reaction. Regardless of the order of a reaction, reactions tend to go faster as the temperature is increased. Arrhenius described this temperature dependence on the rate constant in the following fashion, where A is a large constant that is essentially temperature independent, and Ea is the activation energy. The activation energy is the difference in energy between the reactants and the highest point in the reaction path that brings reactants to products. The activation energy is also essentially temperature independent, but the exponential in which it is found is greatly influenced by the temperature. At very low temperatures, the exponential essentially has a value of zero and the reaction is very slow. At very high temperatures, the exponential approaches one and the reaction rate essentially has the value of A, and the reaction is very fast. Like an equilibrium constant, the rate constant varies with temperature. But, unlike an equilibrium constant that can go up or down with increasing temperature, the rate constant will always increase. Combining the Arrhenius expressions for the rate constant at two different temperatures, we obtain the following expression which allows us to calculate the activation energy, or to calculate the rate constant at another temperature, if we know the activation energy and the rate at one temperature.